Kinokuniya in front of the Dover MRT station on 31st October. Please report to Mr. Low in the staff room immediately.
Hey, do you hear that noise, man? What do you think it's about? You always call without doing the future paper. Why not try to disable that data was about?
No, I'm just lucky.
If I don't have to do it, I won't. If I have to do it, I'll make it quick. That's my motto. And right now, I should follow my motto and come up with some weird conclusion just to show that I'm lucky and not smart.
Okay, fine. I'll try to find out what the announcement was about. As long as you don't bug me afterwards.
Okay, then.
Okay. First, where is Kinokuniya and who is Mr. Low?
Kinokuniya is a small bookstore owned by an elderly couple, and Mr. Low is a discipline master.
So, Mr. Low is probably going to support them.
How do you know?
If Mr. Low wanted to comment them, he wouldn't have used such big words like anyone. He would be more specific. So we know that whoever that knew what the announcement was about would be too scared to go forward. So he wouldn't be commenting his student things. But in any case, whatever the reason, we can tell that the announcement No, that's because the announcement wasn't made in a standard format.
Oh, there's a standard format?
For example, if you were to make an announcement, how would you phrase it?
I would phrase it like this. Guy from S201, meet girl from S201 immediately.
That's all. This is how I would say it. Girl from S209, please meet guy from S201. I repeat, girl from S209, meet guy from S201. Doesn't matter if it was a school announcement or not, because most announcements are repeated twice.
Oh wait.
However, this is not an ordinary announcement, because this announcement was made after school.
Elaborate more, I don't get it.
Basically, students who have went home after school, and yet they made the announcement.
And it's probably so important that they couldn't wait for tomorrow to announce it.
So they were betting on the possibility that student X is still in school. Mr. Low probably didn't want to publicize what he wanted to talk to student X about. So he didn't say why student X was called after.
So what student X did was major enough to be at a higher administrative level.
Wait, this means that student X is probably in very deep trouble?
Yeah, student X is involved in the crime.
Shoplifting was the first thing that came to mind, but if the crime was committed in a totally different place, and yet the investigators found that there was someone fitting the description that went to Kinokuniya, then all types of crimes have taken place.
No, it's not possible. If the investigators were looking for someone in particular, they would have described him in the announcement. So, student X probably committed a crime for shopping at Kinokuniya.
If the announcement was a message for the culprit to turn himself in, no. That doesn't seem right. If I was a culprit, after listening to that announcement, I wouldn't turn myself in.
Let's put aside what crime student X committed and assume that student X regretted what he did and apologized to the elderly couple through a letter.
In a letter?
Tell me what's the date today?
1st November.
Yesterday was 31st October, right? So why would the announcement say 31st October instead of yesterday? Just because the announcer had some form of writing in front of him, which influenced him to say 31st October instead of yesterday. Why would the investigator know that student X is involved and yet knows nothing about student X? Why would the investigator think that student X would turn up to the announcement? Why would the investigators think that student X regrets what he did? Just because student X wrote a letter to Kinokuniya to apologize for what he did due to the overwhelm.
But according to your theory, X wanted to apologize to the store owners, but didn't want the police involved so that it wouldn't write in the letter that they were stealing from a school. So how did the investigators know him to come here?
He would be wearing his uniform, and if he was doing something conspicuous, store owner would be able to call.
Something conspicuous.
This is the part that may be the key to figuring out what crime did X commit. X committed a crime that wasn't noticeable immediately, if not for the letter.
Broke the law when shopping. What crime could possibly happen? Shopping.
X was using counterfeit money.
No, it's not possible. There was no way that X could have gotten their counterfeit money. X couldn't have forged bills good enough to get money from Benjamin and Lizzie. The only way to get the bill is to transfer the pictures. Even if X's father ran a business and received a big deal, X would have figured it out and tell their father, but still, how could X get the counterfeit money? Unless we figure out why they are using counterfeit money, the theory would fall flat.
Do you like money?
I guess I would prefer liking it more than hating it.
So, would you be upset if you threw away your money?
Duh, I mean, who wouldn't?
Exactly. The reason why X felt guilty and still used the bill was because it was their own money. If he can't receive the money as pocket money or from a draw, there's only one possibility that it was given back to them in return for the money they had previously lent. X was troubled after realizing that the money X received was fake and thus felt guilty after using it on a shop run by an elderly couple.
But
didn't
he have changed it?
Counterfeit money is like the Joker in Omi. No one would want to be. So the other person who labeled as Y got money from X. X lent the money to Y, who was in higher social standing, which was the reason why X lent the money to him in the first place. That's why X couldn't object when Y gave them back the money after realizing it was fake. And therefore, based on all this, X is only one person and not a bunch of students. It would be far too unnatural for two or three students to fit in the theory. Also, for student Y, could have gotten it from another person in a similar manner, and the police got involved in the trees where the counterfeit bill came from.